Sir Marty Stone. LSU into the game, their first road game with a record of 2-2. Tigers have won 45 of the 70 meetings. Dale Brown is 24-12 against Florida. And the Gators have played some on the road. They've played in the Great Alaskan Shootout, and they're coming off a pretty hard loss at Illinois the other night when they were swarmed over pretty well by the Fighting Illini. The O'Connell Center holds 12,000. Around 10 or so in attendance for the tip-off here tonight. It'll be Dwayne Shinsis jumping it up against LSU's Richard Kozhevsky, and the Gators have it.
See, a little trick defense. We'll get into a little later, Bob.
That is Livingston Chapman missing from the outside. Chapman has really slimmed down, if you're familiar with him. He's lost about 25 pounds. We should say shed, not really lost. He's worked hard over the summer.
And a small forward now.
Yes, he is. He'll do some shooting from the wing out there.
Speaking of.
Yes,
shooting.
Just inside the three-point line is Chris Jackson, the 6'1 freshman from Gulfport, Mississippi, coming off a 48-point effort against Louisiana Tech.
This is not the freak, but it's a 2-3. Jackson will do a lot of running. They're going to play behind and in front of Shinsis. We'll take a look at it as the game progresses.
And you'll see Dwayne Shinsis pass the ball more than a lot of big men in the country, and there have been a number of turnovers off plays like that one. The Tigers did touch it last, so it's in for the Gators.
Two. Guy in front, a guy in back. They're going to have to beat him outside.
Clifford Lett for two. Shinsis had it bumped away, but Chapman is there on the follow.
Good position. He can beat you in and out.
2-2 as they transition to Ricky Blanton into the paint. Ball was swatted. It'll be goaltending as in the air, Dwayne Davis got a piece of it. And count two for Ricky Blanton, who's averaging 23.
Florida, the man-to-man. Normie can't believe the call. A break for Ricky Blanton. And here's a quick turnover. Shinsis fumbled it.
Turnovers have really been an Achilles heel for this Florida team. 20 a game so far.
Now everybody down here's been at the guards, but the big guys are turning it over. Chapman with 9, and of course the big guy with 6 the other night.
Blanton for Sims, and Wayne averaging 14 has his first two. He's LSU's leading rebound man, and the Tigers have a 6-2 lead. Bill, they've been scoring points this year. LSU, for a change, is struggling to find some defense.
Well, he thinks it's going to come along late this year.
Wayne Sims clears the glass. Blanton at the other end for an easy transition, too.
Sure was. Very heads up. The rookie can do a lot of things. Norm Sloan said he would faint if they didn't press him. He doesn't have to.
Coast to coast goes Clifford Lett, the only senior on the squad and the team captain, averages 16 his first two. It's 8-4 LSU, and we have a foul before the shot. But look at the one-on-one ability of 35 Chris Jackson against Jose Ramos and those Florida guards. Phil, what are they going to do about him tonight?
Well, did you see that crossover move so close to the floor? He's got extraordinary ability with the dribble and good range. They're going to have to pinch. One guy can't play him.
Interesting story with Russell Grant, 22, on the left side. We'll talk about him as the night goes on. A real scrapper. Look at the explosiveness of Chris Jackson to the hoop. Good defense by the Gators, and Florida will get it.
Now, Florida's got everybody down. You'll see the quickness, the speed, blowing by Shintz. It's no match there. I thought it may have been goaltending.
Dwayne Davis up on, or at least very near the glass. Here's Ramos transitioning. And a blocking foul and a basket for Florida.
Good call. Well, that should help him. He needs a confidence builder. That was it. Of course, nothing like rookies playing at home either. I wouldn't want to go to Illinois with all our gray hair and poise. Not an easy road game.
Wayne Sims on the foul. Jose Ramos really trying to get used to the half-court game of Norm Sloan. He was a runner guard in high school. Hasn't played great defense yet. They're waiting for that as well. And tonight, what a test.
Well, Bob, when you think of it, though, he's not comfortable. In high school, he could do anything he wanted and work. Now some of his skills are diminished or taken away, and it's a struggle. And now the head is the problem. Look at that crossover explosion.
There's Russell Grant, short for three. On the offensive rebound, Ricky Blanton, and you'll see those long rebounds off the three-point attempts.
Sure.
Blanton took it right to the hole, and he already has six.
And he was going back for defense and still got the rebound. Look at this. They're trying to get it to Shintz. They've got the big people up front, Krzyzewski there to take away that inbound pass. I don't like too many people down this end. All the white shirts, you bring all the defense in. Versus the preacher man. A character. Known him a long time from his early days as an assistant.
There's Ronaldo Garcia under no pressure, missing. Blanton transitioning. Ramos tries to cut him off. A little too hard from Ricky, and the Gators will have slam time for Shintz.
Oh, the big guys love that. Unattended.
It's a 10-9 game as Florida has come back strong.
Blanton got bumped, though.
And now at the other end, a foul on Richard Krzyzewski. Well, that gets the crowd into it.
Well, it's a pivotal game, more so for Florida. This is just the name of the game for the big guy. That's why they only make it 10 feet. Give them a little enjoyment. Now, was that lazy on his part? He was down there chippy hanging.
He knew they were going to get it back to him. Couple of team fouls on LSU as Ramos against Jackson goes right side to Clifford Lett. Shintz is double teamed, and Ramos from 16. Jose has five.
We heard Dale Brown say today they're going to beat us with the outside shooting. If we can get a couple of minutes out of this defense, fine. If we can extend it, that's as well, too.
The Gators are on a 9-2 run after trailing 8-2. And from outside, it won't go for Jackson. Clearing the boards with 10 boards a game is Dwayne Davis. He actually has more rebounds per game than Dwayne Shintz is right now. They stay up even for the year. They're going to be a tough team to deal with on the boards.
And you talk about impact freshman. Jackson, huh? He can do that clear out for him. He's got a free hand.
Clifford led on that last miss. Here's Blanton using the glass. Offensive foul. Ricky wants to know if the basket counts. It does.
They are pushing the ball up much faster than I've seen the LSU teams in the past. And right here, I thought Blanton got bumped before. I don't know. Score the goal and keep playing.
Timeout on the floor. Offense, the order of the first 4 minutes and 4 seconds. LSU on top, 12-11.
This ESPN Classic program is presented by your neighborhood Ace Hardware, the helpful place.
Ace is having a sale.
The Ace one-day sale is here. Stop in this Friday to save on hundreds of items at Ace, the helpful place.
When you want a moment to last forever, it helps to know the people who know diamonds. Capture the moment with Zales' beautifully crafted princess cut diamond ring. Exclusively at Zales, making moments last a lifetime.
There's a state where there's fun around every corner, where all cars are turbocharged, and there's a direct link between the right foot and a smile. Maybe that's why people who test drive a Saab usually buy one. This is the state of independence.
The turbocharged Saab 9.3 Linear Sports Sedan. Available in the state of Independence for as low as $299 a month.
League MVP. Innovator. Grand Champion. Acrobat. Peacekeeper. Enforcer. Record holder. Freedom fighter. Sharpshooter. All-star. Fireman. Exterminator. World champion, commander. It's never too late for a career change. Products rating pending through mature. PlayStation 2, the only place to play.
What's the secret of success?
You start with an insight, a vision,
an indicator.
There is no secret.
No secret. It's 1% inspiration.
Followed by midnight oil.
Lots of elbow grease.
Determination.
Sheer, stubborn,
relentless.
Determination.
Where there's a will,
there's always a way.
Provided, of course, you know what you're doing.
I don't know anyone.
Who's better trained than we are?
You want results?
Come prepared.
Stay late.
Smith Barney.
This is who we are.
This is how we earn it.
If I wear black, even a little dandruff shows.
And my old dandruff shampoo just wasn't doing enough.
So I switched. Selsun Blue Moisturizing Shampoo. Doctor recommended for flakes and itch.
With aloe and moisturizers for healthier hair and scalp.
Never wear black without the blue.
Selsun Blue.
Oh, nice ball, Walter.
Only the Fairley Brothers, the directors of There's Something About Mary.
Hey, you guys are stuck together.
And Shallow Hal could make a film about brothers. This close.
I'm not going another step until you apologize.
Don't you walk away from me.
Yeah, you better run.
Matt Damon, Greg Kinnear.
Let's never do anything that makes us look like total idiots.
Stuck on You.
I'm open.
Rated PG-13, December 12th, only in theaters.
Home is where the hoop is.
With ESPN Full Court, you'll get more than 450 additional games of college basketball. To order, call your local cable company, DirecTV at 1-800-DIRECTV, or Dish Network at 1-800-333-DISH.
Latrell Sprewell.
He had a tremendous temper. He was going to come after you.
A Sports Century Monday world premiere, December 1st. From Playing with Fire.
On the court, he's all out war.
To a reputation up in flames.
Sprewell is going to be scarred for that forever.
Can he escape his past?
This is the most difficult thing that I've had to deal with in my life.
Sports Century, Latrell Sprewell. A Monday world premiere, 8 p.m. December 1st. Only on ESPN Classic.
Welcome back to the O'Connell Center in Gainesville, Florida. With Bill Raftery, Bob Carpenter. A lot of offense here so far, Coach.
I'm impressed with Dale Brown playing it up and down, a little woo-woo. And yet, if this defense can hang in for him, he could be pretty tough at the end of the... That was short. It couldn't go in.
Right. And then fumbled out of bounds by Richard Kajewski. And so it'll belong back to the Gators on... A little miscue by the 6'10 sophomore from North Dakota. He was became a starter after this team lost to Oral Roberts at home 196. Dale Brown didn't like what he saw that night and made some significant changes in this team.
Gonna force you in.
Ramos
gotta make him.
Yeah, he was looking for his 6th and 7th points and he couldn't knock it down.
Good shot then of the defense to see how they're playing Shinsis. Look at this.
Oh, he is so relaxed.
So confident.
Chris Jackson came in shooting 50% from three-point range. He commits a foul in the backcourt.
Nickel dime. Got to move the feet and extend.
You know, the 48 points he has scored at the Pete Maravich Center, a record for a freshman in that building. Of course, Pete Maravich didn't get the chance to play in that building. And the previous high was 40. He had 48. Pete, by the way, does have the LSU record with 69.
We were trying to figure out if it is a freshman record, since freshmen became eligible in 74. The only one I could think of is maybe Fly Williams at Austin Peay. But
Chintz is on the miss, and then looking for the offensive board. Dwayne Davis over the top for his first foul.
I was impressed in the workout. Storm Sloan yesterday, very relaxed, didn't you think? A lot of guys after a terrible performance would have been all over their club. He went through a few things, tried the different guard combos, and said, look, if we get pressed, let's get it. Look at this.
They better get in his face. That's two straight three-pointers, and Jackson, averaging a team-leading 27, has eight already, and LSU is a sizzling 8 of 11 from the field.
No wonder Dale's so relaxed. He's got CJ.
He's got offense. Look at the big move of Clifford Lett, and a block by Richard Kajewski.
Great help. Sims over there to help as well.
Blanton in for Sims.
Cut.
Ooh, what a touch.
Well, they're the two strongest guys of the team, huh? Sims, they say, may be the strongest ever in the program, according to their conditioning people.
And watch him on defense, because he knows how to block shots. Being tall isn't the only requirement for blocking shots.
Let's see if they switch. Now they're still in it.
Down deep. And it'll be a foul on LSU's Richard Kajewski as Dwayne Davis took the ball down low.
He got over there a little bit late, but he took a shot and paid for it right here. You see, he's playing Shinsis now. He reads the lob, gets down. Got to let the guy come down. Good call. Good call. He didn't move forward when he caught it. He came right up and down.
Ronaldo Garcia checks out. There's Livingston Chapman back in, a freshman All-American and an All-SEC freshman a year ago. Garcia did not start the game. Gave Chapman a brief breather. Let looking right side for the man they call Liv. Three scope knee surgeries last year. They even drain that knee occasionally. You see it heavily taped right
nice
part of your
pass.
Screen.
Maybe what he does best. Of course, he can see the floor at that size easily.
Yes, sir. He's got a good shooting touch, too.
He does. Just... Look at this. I mean, that's confidence. And then when you get a loose arm, the coach gives you permission.
Well, you know, he had that 48. Jackson did against Louisiana Tech. He got off to a slow start against McNeese. They said, keep on shooting. He'll keep laying one up here.
Well,
and into double figures with 10.
He's got a free reign. That arm can hang loose all night. He can drill it. He doesn't have to look to the bench for the hook.
But, Bill, what about the significance of that, telling a freshman to keep on shooting? That's something to consider.
Well, don't forget, he has a lot of problems with the ineligibles, as does Florida. But I think they need his scoring. They're not a prolific scoring team, although Blanton certainly can complement them.
As Florida needs Dwayne Chintz's down deep. Gators down by 9 after the jump hook by Dwayne, who has 4. Blanton trying to use a pick of Krajewski.
See, the whole area is a one-on-one routine for he's so quick, CJ.
There's Ricky Blanton, jumper left side. He can do it inside, he can go outside, and Ricky's into double figures with 10.
Doesn't it feel like he's been around forever?
5 years?
Yeah.
That seems like forever.
Well, he had the bad knee a couple of years ago when I was down at LSU. In fact, I asked him tonight if his folks were coming here, or any of his family said no, that they usually, again, number 3, just a step late. And really, that's not paying attention to the coach. They will permit Shinsis to get the basketball. Krajewski came by and tried to steal it.
That's big trouble for LSU because Krajewski now has 3 fouls, and they're missing one of their big men who can be an important contributor. We talked about the Prop 48 thing earlier. They are missing some unbelievable freshmen who are not eligible. There's the transition to Grant, and he can't get the roll as Blanton fed him down the floor.
Good hustle by Florida. You're thinking of Stanley Roberts for one, I'm sure. Of course, Johnny Walker here and Stacy Cole.
Yeah, the Gators have 1 injured and 1 on Prop 48. LSU has 3. They've also have 2 outstanding high school seniors that are already signed, sealed, and soon to be delivered for next season.
It's always been a great ground for recruiting, though, Florida.
Oh.
I can remember years ago, George Raveling came from Villanova down here. Johnny Jones.
Why not? Tigers 24, Gators 13. We're almost 8 minutes in.
This is Titanium. one of the sharpest metals known to man. Now available in a somewhat more manageable size. The new Remington Titanium Series. The world's only shaver with the sharpness of titanium-coated trimmer blades. For a shave that's incredibly close and comfortable. Remington Titanium. It could just make all other shavers obsolete.
Great teams are often forged over the hot coals of adversity. On the eve of the big meeting, the third quarter numbers suddenly changed. But so did your presentation, automatically. You have the new Microsoft Office system. It's a Cinderella story.
All right, here's the play. Sunday night at 8. Go to ESPN Classic. Stop at the couch, and the best sports movies of all time will be right there.
Real classics with Burt Reynolds.
Where sports and movies collide.
It'll be a classic Saturday night at 7, Classic Baseball. It's the Indians and the Mariners from 2001. Then at 10, NFL Game of the Week presents the Bengals-Chargers Showdown from 85. Tonight on ESPN Classic.
Dish On Demand pay-per-view now offers more movie channels than ever before. More channels mean the exciting new movies you want to see are on more often throughout the day. Tune to channels 502 through 538 in your on-screen guide and check out the great new movies on TV for the first time. You can order with your remote control or call 1-877-DISH-PPV. So check out the new channels and order a Dish On Demand pay-per-view movie today.
Well, I hope Roger found enough firewood.
Yeah, I want to make s'mores.
Hey, guys, I gathered the wood and made a fire.
Oh, yeah, and I built a shelter.
Even as a kid, I believed in giving people a little more than they expected. I'm Roger Riney. I started Scottrade to take care of online investors like nobody else. With $7 trades, no inactivity fees, and personal attention at your local office. Click, call, or stop by Scottrade today.
Almost 8 minutes into the first half, Florida on top, and the confident shooting of Chris Jackson from out on top.
Well, the thing here is the whole court is a one-on-one area. Use the three-second lane, extend it to work. He's so quick, so good with the dribble. I think you're going to have to run people at him.
Chris
Jackson
and
another guy.
Ricky Blanton have 20 of LSU's 24 points. And there you see he has 10, so does Ricky. And Florida has 5 from Jose Ramos, who's been pretty good offensively himself so far as he lets one fly, but that's way long. Shinsis on the tip, a long tip, got his own and can't hit it, and Livingston Chapman can't lay it in. But a foul is whistled, and it'll be on Dwayne Davis, his second.
Pretty impressive glass work. I think Dwayne Shinsis has to become more aggressive in his shooting. I think he passes up a lot of shots. I mean, it's terrific the way he passes, but to get them out of the doldrums when he gets it, they're putting too much pressure on the outside shooting.
So LSU by 11. Florida had a 9-2 run. The Tigers have answered.
1-2-2 or 3-2, pretty flat. See Chapman in the middle.
Grant had Davis way up off the floor. They get it inside. Sims from Blanton.
Nice pass.
Wayne Sims has the only points that Jackson and Blanton don't, and LSU leads it by 13.
Now, the more you see Blanton, the more you appreciate him, don't you? He's got some talent.
Well, he's always around the ball. And if he's not, he's picking for someone or helping out on defense, like right there.
Great slide.
And you got to pressure him, and he'll shoot the jumper. Gets it into Sims, a little short. Shinsis off the chest of Hamming, who just checked in. He's on the floor diving, and it still plays for Blanton and LSU. Gert Hamming, a 6'11 freshman out of the Netherlands, getting down and dirty early.
How about that for poise? What do you mean, they don't go for balls in Europe? Is that...
He's not tired after the long trip over. And Sims has 8.
That's twice now that they've been able to cut. Nobody's stopping him. Nobody defending.
28-13. A 15-point LSU lead. We're 10.5 minutes from halftime.
Now the guards aren't so sure they want to shoot. They're passing up opportunities. And that's the pressure that this defense has put on them.
Ricky Blanton bumped it out of bounds. And Dale Brown's defense looking pretty good at this point. That was his big concern coming in. They're averaging on the year 97 points a game, but they've been beaten up on the boards.
Mm-hmm.
An average of 11 rebounds a game less than their opponents.
Good kick. Played some pretty good people, though. They're not household names. Louisiana Tech, people remember a few years ago when Carl Malone was down there. They won the state championship in Louisiana the other night, huh? Yeah,
they hadn't played LSU in a while. That was a big win for Tech.
Back when you were a youngster.
Yeah, I remember that. 10-10 left, first half. Chapman goes inside, strong, and that's out of bounds off Sims. One thing about the Gators, they're living up to our pregame billing of being tough inside. LSU is finding it hard to grab a clean defensive rebound.
Got bumped, too. Should have been at the free throw line.
Inside, Chinsis. Off for Lett for two. Clifford can't hit it. And Ricky Blanton near the baseline has it. Outlets for Chris Jackson. Oh, Hammack, a great pass for Jackson. And Chapman with a block.
Great play.
Possession will belong to LSU as Gerd Hammack came out of nowhere to tie up Jose Ramos.
I thought, when you think of what Dale Brown has done, the jump defense, but look at the running ability. You talk about the knee problems. Chapman, very aggressive play. And here, you shouldn't really bring the ball into your body like that. Ramos will learn to extend it and use that pivot foot.
Ricky Blanton has 12, a foul in the backcourt on Russell Grant. You know, Ricky Blanton against Oral Roberts a couple of weeks ago had a big first half. ORU of Ken Trickey went to a zone. LSU couldn't hit from outside. What about Florida possibly trying that as well? Do they have the good enough defense out front to do it?
The problem was they were open in the middle. Twice they got the ball to Sims. He was able to register. But I'm amazed what Dale Brown has done. It's a junk defense, for one thing. They press to put the pressure on the guards, and then they put the pressure on the guards in making the outside shot with this defense.
Russell Grant into the crowd. It'll belong to Florida, and you're seeing vintage number 22. Russell Grant is called by the LSU coaches the least talented but hardest working player on the LSU team. He's simply taken the position away from guys like Lyle Mouton and also Lester Scott. They just got outplayed by this hustler.
Well, they love the way he plays. He's a kind of a kid. Apparently the other night he came up with the play of the game. Same kind of thing, only it led to a basket.
Kyle McKenzie, a guy who was expected to play a lot, but Grant has beat him out. Florida keeps on scrapping now. 9:38 remaining in the first half. LSU 30, Florida 13. Gators need a run like the 9-2 they had earlier. Two fouls now on Chris Jackson.
I don't think they gave him a foul. I'm not sure they gave him a foul. I think they said he was out of bounds.
Let's check the team fouls. They did not. Let's see. They did, because there are four team fouls now on the Gators.
Okay. I thought they said he stepped out. Right here, Hogan in the game trying to get some semblance of order. Norm Sloan struggling, getting the ball to the right spots. Again, Chinsis, when he gets it, great passer. I think I'd like to see him shoot the shot.
Good rotation, but it won't fall. Sims clears it. Chris Jackson already with 10 points. He just simply froze Brian Hogan, and Hogan's a good defensive guard.
Well, you can't just have one guy play him. I mean, I think you got to put some pressure on the other people.
That was a two-pointer by Jackson. 32-13 LSU.
Russell tagging on.
Russell Grant.
Pretty impressive LSU group, though.
17 fouls now on the Tigers, so the Gators in a position where they can make up some of that deficit with the clock not moving here. With 9:05 remaining, first half. To the line will go senior Clifford Lett.
You know, the problem hasn't been with the press too much. It's the half-court offense.
Lett playing in his 97th career game in Florida. Eclipsed in this ballgame only by Ricky Blanton.
Some sarcasm with that free throw.
Ricky Blanton's playing in his 103rd game tonight.
Well, I got to stop him. Man to man. One guy can't do it.
Jackson for Russell Grant. Goes baseline. That opens up Jackson. He was on the line, so the two misses, and Blanton has it baseline. Reverse layup.
That's knowing where you are. Giveaway right here. Home run pass. Nice play.
Clifford Lett.
Great look.
End-to-end action here.
Is this confidence?
Oh. Ricky Blanton for three. 17 in the first half for Rick, who's averaging 23.
Bad.
And a steal by Jackson, but he was on the baseline when he came down.
Funny, you make a few shots, all of a sudden the press picks up. You come up with a couple of freebies. Don't give away that long one to come up with a steal. But just look where Hogan went. That was an impossible place to catch the ball. And, of course, the easy step in, unfortunately, for LSU on the line.
Hogan for Shinsis.
All right.
And a follow over the top. Davis over Sims. And Dwayne couldn't get it to fall. So it's Russell Grant for LSU waiting for his teammates to get back down court.
Well, they can't ring the bell at all, can they? Missing easy ones. Still man to man.
Sims with a high arching turnaround. Shinsis had it bumped away by Hammock. And a left-handed one by Dennis Tracy.
How did he get in there?
Dennis Tracy, known for his defense and ball handling, just did a dandy job of finishing a two-pointer.
There's the man-to-man now. Last couple of trips.
Chapman going right down the paint.
That's amazing.
Sims, there must be a lid at that end of the court right now.
Chapman a little frustrated. Just saw him shaking his head. Little bump.
Hogan moving with Ricky Blanton. And it'll be a foul. Bryan's first.
He's got explosiveness in his moves off the dribble.
7:22 remaining in the first half. 39-17 LSU. Florida checks in 41 Michael Kerr, an outside linebacker on the football team. Seeing action here tonight. 7:22 first half. Tigers by 22.
Before Mr. Taylor taught the world to play, before fiberglass, before parquet, before the word doctor was spelled with a J, and ballrooms were ball courts where the Renaissance played, before the hype and before the dunk, after the rhythm, but before the funk, before the money and before the fame, before new and old school, before school had a name, it was only the ball and the soul of the game. First school, Converse, only at Champ Sports.
Oh. Ace is having a sale.
The Ace One Day Sale is here. Stop in this Friday to save on hundreds of items at Ace, the helpful place.
This is the sound. These are the results. Can you feel it? Can you hear it? This is the sound of the Power Flex by Gold's Gym, the authority since 1965. Gold's Gym gives you one powerful machine with 65 club quality exercises and up to 410 pounds of resistance to build muscle, define muscle, lose fat, all in just 6 weeks or less to get you the body you've always wanted, guaranteed. The secret to the Power Flex begins with the swivel flex pulleys that provide you with free range of motion so you can move from one exercise to the next safely. Next, Power Stroke Resistance simulates the natural movement of your muscles and allows you to move from 10 to 410 pounds of resistance with one simple stroke. It's this awesome combination that gives you those ripped abs and more chiseled arms, legs, chest, and back. If you want to look like this, then you need this. Power Flex, the Gold's Gym technology breakthrough. Call now for free information about how you can get the Gold's Gym Power Flex in your home for as little as $49 a month. With the Gold's Gym Power Flex, you get the lat tower, the multi-position bench, hip strap, rowing seat, ankle strap, handles, and space saver design. Be one of the first callers, and you'll get the Gold's Gym Power Flex Leg Developer for stronger legs and shapelier hips and thighs. A $200 value, absolutely free. You'll also get a workout poster showing you all 65 club quality exercises. Our gift to you. Don't pay $2,000 for a home gym that won't get you authentic Gold's Gym results. This is the machine. These are the results. Can you feel it?
Call 1-800-700-0857 to get the Gold Gym Power Flex in your home for as little as $49 a month. That's 1-800-700-0857. Call now.
Just like America, hockey's become great through the contributions of immigrants. And here at the factory, we follow that example. Point is even though we're all from different cultures, we all speak hockey and English. Mostly.
The NHL on ESPN.
What's classic?
Let the celebration begin!
Classic is...
He did it! He did it! Touchdown, Nebraska!
Classic was...
I don't believe what I just saw!
Classic will always be...
Gretzky! All the band is out on the field!
Holy mackerel!
Darher turnaround shot in the air! Let's do it! And this shot will last the lifetime!
Now that's classic.
Barry Sanders.
It's like trying to catch a fly and you just can't catch the guy.
A Sports Century world premiere Monday.
50, 40, 30. Holy mackerel.
A master playmaker.
He is putting on a show.
But on the verge of immortality.
As a son, this is not the time to quit.
I knew that I was walking away from something that was wonderful.
Sanders said goodbye.
It's still a mystery to me why he quit.
Sports Century Barry Sanders premieres 8 p.m. Monday on ESPN Classic.
We played almost 13 minutes of the first half, and the Tigers of LSU have been awesome on the road here tonight. 39-17. Diving. Chris Jackson blocked, but before that he was fouled. It looks like Clifford Lett got him as he flashed by.
I can't believe his great first, second, and third steps. Can shoot it.
All right, thank you, Steve Fizziak and Steve Rabel with Bill Raftery. This is Bob Carpenter at the O'Connell Center in Gainesville, Florida. 7:14 left, first half. The LSU Tigers coach have been outstanding tonight, and Chris Jackson at the line has now scored his 13th point of the night. Ricky Blanton already has 17.
Efficient on offense. This is one of the great freshmen in the country. Of course, everybody who follows basketball, Blanton has been sensational during his career at LSU, and they just can't buy a basket at the other end. Florida doing a pretty good job against the press. It's just not shooting well.
Look at that score. 41-17. The Gators can't hit any easy shots.
Number 13, Dennis Tracy,
LSU is on a 30-6 run here. 7:09 remaining in the first half. This was once a 10-9 ball game.
Extraordinary. And really not a whole lot of bad shots by Florida, nor a lot of turnovers. It's just a matter of not converting. And of course, I can't get over the speed pushing the ball down the floor that LSU possesses.
Ryan Hogan hits both. He's now 3-for-4 from the line this year. A transition other end for Dennis Tracy. Jackson, look how quick. Look at missing that time. Ricky Blanton manhandling people for the rebound, getting the ball cleanly. Missing for three, Tracy. And the rebound for Florida's Dwayne Davis.
Blanton shows you how competitive he is, doesn't he?
Hogan for Chapman. Livingston.
They're getting
inside the line for two, and Florida needed that.
He can make them. That might not be a bad move, letting him come outside, take a lot of pressure off the guards.
Inside player last year when he averaged 13 a game. He's got the same average with one more rebound, seven as an inside-outside player rather this year.
Oh,
back door, Dennis Tracy.
Michael Kerr went over to help check out. All he had to do was stay in position. Oh, that's a shame. Can't do anything right.
Shinsis is back up and will be coming in shortly. This is Clifford Lett for Livingston Chapman.
Man to man. He keeps switching from the doodad defense. Nice pass.
Over the top of Blanton, and he took it right away from Dwayne Davis. Ricky beaten on the play, then comes up with a steal to the hoop, and he draws the foul.
He just knows the game, and how about the rook giving it up early, letting the senior, look at him, he just patted him on the shoulder.
Oh,
the big guy. Tell you what, he's in the game now. They got to get some inside game. There's the help by Blanton. They're trying to front when they can, and Shinsis is out. When he's in, they stand behind him. But look at Jackson giving it up in plenty of time for Blanton to go to work.
Look at that shooting by LSU. Tigers came in hitting 48%. Florida came in hitting 50. But again, turnovers were their problem. Tonight, missing easy shots added to that as Michael Kerr steps back in and taking a seat as Dwayne Davis.
With those shooting percentages, Norm is looking at one of the assistants and saying, who's in charge of shooting? You, Monty, as in Tao?
Dale Brown with Ron Abernathy, his 13-year assistant coach.
The unsung heroes, really. The big guys tip the hat, usually get most of the speaking engagements and a few other frills, which they deserve, but the guys behind the scene put in that daily effort.
Let me tell you, Ricky Blanton is like a child at play out there. He's letting himself dictate this game. Unless the Gators stop him, they're in big trouble tonight. He has an unbelievable first half going. And there he gets a defensive rebound after a few tips by his teammates.
But Jackson just gives it up regardless of who. Look at this.
There's a 360, a double, triple pump, and he misses, but he's fouled by Jose Ramos.
And now he's telling his teammates where to go, where they should have been. I mean, this is the poise of a junior or a senior, but the ability to spin out of trouble, to read ahead. Look at this.
Oh.
That's extraordinary. Now, that's not a walk either. He put the ball on the floor before he picked up the pivot foot. The kiss doesn't go, but he's got it.
You know, he made a good play initially just to catch the pass before he did any of that.
Right? Poise.
Chris Jackson is out of Gulfport, Mississippi, 6'1", 170, a high school All-American, a two-time Mississippi Player of the Year. He averaged 30 points and 6 assists per game as a senior. For LSU, he's hitting 69% from the line. You know, they say that a lot of folks have wanted to buy season tickets since he showed up because they know in a year or two it's going to be tough to get a ticket to the Pete Maravich Assembly Center in Baton Rouge.
Well, we mentioned Stanley Roberts, Maurice Williamson, John's son, Harold Boudreau, apparently a very good prospect as well.
All three will be sophomores. There's Jackson with a steal, but he dribbled it off his toe out of bounds.
He's trying to make a play before he really had it, but they've been stepping in of late. The offense has got their defense going. It's normally the other way right here. You can't make long passes against quick players.
Schintz is pivoting it, leaving it off for Jose Ramos. 5:25 first half, 47-21 LSU. Clifford Lett tries to take two away from that, and Clifford has eight. He's having a good first half.
LSU has to keep up the pressure. They can't just get a little tough pass here. First mistake I think I've seen him make.
Yeah, they played almost flawlessly. Wayne Sims couldn't get the roll. And over the top of Michael Kerr will be Richard Kerchekin. It's Gert Hemming.
They learn how to holler in the Netherlands after the official, after that call.
He played for the European Junior National Team, did Hemming, a couple of years ago.
Remember when Dale went after the State Department to try and get some Russian players, went up to Washington? There's this guy.
Michael Kerr knocks it down. A 6'6 freshman out of Miami. He's an outside linebacker on the football team of Galen Hall. He practiced football. He redshirted this year, but practiced up until the time that preseason basketball practice got underway. Oh, there's a tip by Livingston Chapman.
Maybe that'll get him going.
Three-point play for the Gators. Under 5 minutes, first half. It's still a 21-point spread.
Oh, little dipsy-do. Fade back, baby. Dick Barnett, I'm really thrilled to get a chance to see him this early in his career because it means we'll be watching him for a long time. CJ, you got it, kid.
Oh, Schintzis gets into it with Gert Hemming.
Frustrated.
And a dead ball foul on Dwayne Schintzis as he loses his cool. Let's take another look at the man they'll be calling CJ for a long time.
This is a little dance. I don't think you have these moves on the floor, but just banging him from deep. What confidence, and right into the press.
Jackson has 19. So does Ricky Blanton. Gert Hemming will be at the line. Five countries have sent players to LSU. They, of course, call him Dutch because he's from the Netherlands. First player from that country, too. Travel to play to Baton Rouge.
Well, they got it going their way right now. See, Norm just didn't sit there. He's put a lot of kids in to try and shake his club. He's not a deep team with 10.
Bottom of your screen, Ronaldo Garcia back in, teaming with Clifford Lett. Shinsis was looking at Chapman down the paint.
That's what he's got to do, though. Take the shot.
He's got a great touch for the big man, and there's nothing clumsy about Shinsis at 7'2", 265.
He's so unselfish. Nice pump fake.
He was sent off the floor that time by Dennis Tracy. This almost looks like an LSU team in February or March, the way they're picking it
up. Not a good one. And he gets there, spares the backcourt.
Garcia! Ronaldo Garcia, sophomore out of Tampa, did not play last year because of Prop 48. And it's under 20 now as Florida gets it back to 49-30. 3:50 left first half. The crowd back in, that could really help the Gators.
CJ just looked to the bench and said, my fault.
Turnover.
Look at Norman. Go get him! I'll tell you, he's got some fire.
Gert Hammack threw it away, and we have a timeout on the floor. 3:46 remaining. Tigers by 19 over the Gators.
Ace is having a sale.
The Ace One Day Sale is here. Stop in this Friday to save on hundreds of items at Ace, the helpful place.
Welcome back. I'm here in this 19th century Victorian with new owners Mike and Shannon Boyd.
Hi, Ted.
We just fell in love with its charm.
Yeah, it's charming. Unfortunately, the roof leaks, the foundation is crumbling, and there's significant termite damage. But I do have good news. I just saved a bunch of money on my car insurance by switching to Geico. Hey, we need to talk about your electrical.
Whoa.
We're going to want to fix that.
Geico. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
It's a blockbuster Friday doubleheader on ESPN. First, the Cavaliers face the Pistons. Then, the defending champion Spurs take on the new-look Lakers. Doubleheader coverage begins at 7:30 Friday on ESPN.
On Thanksgiving night, for the first time ever, number one Notre Dame, number two Michigan State, the epic battle one more time. The exclusive rebroadcast of the Game of the Century. Plus, Bubba Smith and Rocky Blyer relive the dramatic...
There was some vicious hitting going on.
...and controversial game...
I really felt let down. I felt disappointed.
...that changed college football forever. Classic Big Ticket, the Game of the Century. 7 Eastern Thanksgiving night, only on ESPN Classic.
It's just the Smiths again.
They only have cable.
Give the gift of Dish Network and get $60 each time a friend joins. Up to $720 per year and you could lose your bill. Call to get your free gift cards.
I was tired of working in kitchens and warehouses, making minimum wage. I needed a career change. I decided to go to ITT Tech. I think it may have been the best decision I ever made. Now I have a career instead of just a job. I'm confident about my future. I no longer have to live with the constant uncertainty of going from paycheck to paycheck. I'm finally feeling free.
We are educators helping people build a foundation for the rest of their lives. ITT Technical Institute, education for the future.
For information, call 1-800-338-4715.
We pick up the action at the start of the second half with LSU leading Florida 54-37.
Welcome back to the O'Connell Center in Gainesville, home of the Florida Gators, regrouping at the moment, Bill Raftery.
They had better. I know Norman doesn't want to be embarrassed at home, and I'm sure he's pleading with his troops to, hey, go out and guard and be aggressive. They just are so laid back. And, of course, seeing them the last couple of years, it's not the same type of team.
Dwayne Davis came into the game averaging 15 points and 10 boards a game. Has a couple of rebounds, but obviously not on the board scoring-wise. He has a couple of fouls. This could be a very special night for Dale Brown. As we said earlier, he's after a milestone win in his career tonight. At midcourt, right in front of us, Florida will start with a basketball. And 20 short minutes remaining as far as the Gators are concerned. By the way, coming up next, we'll go to the Big East. Seton Hall is playing St. John's tonight. You'll see that one on ESPN as we get on with more college basketball this evening. That's what the Gators need.
Get him the basketball and stop the baloney. Jeez. You got a 7'2" guy, might as well go sell programs.
Sims and Shinsis battle for the rebound, and Shinsis watches it go out of bounds, belonging to the Gators. Dwayne has 10 on the night now.
Get down on the box and put your hand up.
He has 4 rebounds on the night, 10 and 4 for the 7'2" junior of Florida.
Here's the jump. Nice look.
Underneath to Davis. The pass was on his shoulder, and he couldn't grab it.
Tough spot.
Here's Ricky Blanton. He's been unbelievable tonight.
Good rebound.
Davis says, if I'm not going to score, I'm going to wipe that glass.
Someplace.
Ramos throws it away.
It was deflected now. It was deflected.
Norm Sloan is looking right into the face of Jose Ramos and says, I want a timeout to talk to you and the guys not running off the ball. 51 seconds gone in the second half. Gators have already called a timeout.
Have yourself a merry little Christmas. Let your heart be light. Next year all our troubles will be out of sight. So have yourself a merry little Christmas.
This holiday season, put out the good stuff. Planters.
Revolution will be televised.
ESPN High Definition Television is here. ESPN HD brings viewers its premier sports. The National Football League, the National Basketball Association, Major League Baseball, the National Hockey League, and more of the sports you love from the people who do it best.
Wow!
ESPN HD will be more than an evolution. ESPN HD will be a revolution in resolution. ESPN brings wildly enhanced clarity, allowing you to see the power play develop from net to net. Steal a side. See the sweat spray. Behold the whole field. The best seat in the house will be in your house.
Revolution will be televised.
With ESPN HD, it's front row, center court, ringside, on the screen like you've never seen, with 5 times the clarity of regular definition television. The revolution in resolution is here. ESPN HD, the big picture in sports. Available nationwide. Visit your local retailer to see it for yourself. Call your cable operator or satellite provider today. ESPN HD, sponsored exclusively by Philips and Best Buy.
From Smirnoff Ice Triple Black Premium Malt Beverage, proud sponsor of Matt Kenseth and the number 17 car.
Oh. Ace is having a sale.
The Ace One Day Sale is here. Stop in this Friday to save on hundreds of items at Ace, the helpful place.
We've got some of Miami's biggest bowl games in history. The Hurricanes blow away the Cornhuskers in the 92 Orange Bowl. Miami wrestles the Gators in the 2001 Sugar Bowl. The Canes capture their 5th national title in 2002's Rose Bowl Triumph. Plus, a true Orange Bowl classic, 84's Down to the Wire showdown with Nebraska. And so much more. Classic Miami starts at noon Eastern, 9 a.m. Pacific, Sunday, only on ESPN Classic. Brought to you locally by Comcast.
Woo!
And a man.
A minute into the second half, Florida has used the timeout to change some things. Chris Jackson, can they change his output? That time they did. Just off the floor.
Doesn't make many mistakes, huh? Left the floor there.
That's only about two he's made tonight, really. There was one other time he was forcing in the first half.
Nice pass along the baseline.
And up, baby.
Livingston. Chapman into double figures with the jam. And it's a 13-point game. LSU with 5:33 left in the first half, led by 26. So it's taken the Gators 15 minutes to cut that lead in half. And near the ball, that will be number three on Dwayne Davis.
LSU now has to have some composure, spread the floor, run their set, and then settle for the jumper. Jackson came down, of course, quickly. This is where Blant is very tough when they need something.
Russell Grant knocks it in for Ricky Blanton, who in the first half had 19 to go with 22 from Chris Jackson.
I'll tell you where Blant would be tough in that point forward philosophy of a Don Nelson. Don't you think?
Look at the good ball movement and traveling on Richard Kajewski.
Little bump, but you got to maintain your position.
Tigers move the ball around well. They did not finish. We'll see if Florida can get some momentum after that early timeout from Norm Sloan.
Man to man now. Bale figuring he's going to take it to them a little bit now.
Ramos for Shinsis. Let on the wing against Russell Grant. Davis skying for a touch, and he was fouled.
What a rebound in traffic.
Hey, that's a big play in this ballgame, Bill. Looks like number four on Wayne Sims.
You know, Norm's wife was singing before the game. What do you think he was singing in the locker room? Right here, nothing but sheer power and aggressive play, something that has been absent all evening.
Wayne Sims with four fouls has to leave. Dale Brown calls on a freshman, Vernell Singleton, who actually is listed as a guard, but started at center earlier this year. His natural position is forward. Ramos, Shinsis kicks it out for Clifford Lett, but he can't finish. Singleton picks up the easy bouncing rebound.
Great look. Now you say, well, maybe he should have held on. Nice play.
Back door! Chris Jackson, up into the air. He has 24, and LSU gets it back with some tough defense on the inbounds play.
Clifford Lett, let me tell you, the alley-oop from forwards and centers, normally, Krzyzewski clears out for home. CJ!
That is something.
And then Russell Grant, the first half, you caught him going into the bench head first. He got the foul on Clifford Lett.
There's a drive and two for Singleton.
Good pressure here.
Okay, these Tigers ready to play here tonight. They have come into this tough building. We told you earlier, Florida is 40-4 in this building.
Nice.
Chapman. Grant. And a foul by Grant, evidently on Clifford Lett.
I don't know. I thought it was Russell Grant in there with the dig and scratch, but a great look. Post pass play. Chapman does take up some space.
Three on Grant. The slim 6'7", 230 Livingston Chapman at the line.
How many did he lose?
25, they say. He has 11. You know, there were a couple of reasons for that, too. Of course, we mentioned earlier, he's gone from the inside out to the outside. A little mobility will help. He also wanted to take a little bit of weight off to give that knee a break that was scoped three different times last season. 15-point game, 17 minutes left, and Ramos.
He got away with that. CJ extended the arm, and don't forget, you don't have to be standing still to get an offensive foul. I thought he did a pretty good job. It's tough enough right here. And you see the arm? Now, that's that's a bang banger, but still, you got to have a little control when you've got the ball.
I'll tell you, there are some SEC coaches watching here tonight that must be wondering, how are we going to guard Chris Jackson?
Mm-hmm. I think they got to run somebody at him, to be honest.
Shintz is fouled by Russell Grant.
Oh, is he into the game? No, that's great.
Being aggressive is a great thing for this guy because, as the LSU coaches say, the least talented but hardest working player for Dale Brown. But now he has four fouls, and Dale will have to call on Dennis Tracy.
How would you like to be Russell Grant? The coach calls you and says, look, why don't you try another school? You're not good enough for this program, and I like it. I want to see you play.
He scored 3 points all of last year.
And I said to him tonight before the game, look, you had to work on your game, didn't you? And he said, yeah, I worked real hard. I wasn't too good. And they're going into the well now. That's what they have to do. That's number four.
That's four on Krajewski. Shinsis drawing the foul as they got the ball down deep to him. 16:47 remaining. You can feel in this building that something is changing.
Nice pass.
Shinsis to Chapman.
Great cut, too. I'll tell you, these two have taken over. The inside people, they're much stronger, don't forget, than LSU in tight.
Gators back to within 13. They once trailed by 26. They haven't been able to get much closer than 13 or 11. Jackson with an air ball. Shinsis with the rebound.
Now he's starting to play a little bit like a freshman. He's got to relax, CJ, get his composure.
Chapman baseline left, and he turned it over.
The jump there, the defense should have dumped it back out.
LSU has three players with four fouls. Wayne Sims, Richard Krajewski, and Russell Grant. Ricky Blanton stripped. Chapman gives it to Ramos, and here come the Gators.
Jose with the hand in. Nice help.
Chapman to Shinsis. Stripped of the ball on his hip, but fouled in the process.
I think they give it to Singleton. Blanton was down there, too, but at least they're cognizant that Wayne is under there. I mean, that first half, he could have been on the bench. Dale had them puzzled. They didn't look for him.
Well, there are the three we told you with four. Humming also has some. The good news is Ricky Blanton only has one foul in the game tonight. So Tracy with a foul.
He just couldn't get the shot off there, Dwayne. Again, he's very pass conscious. Norm wants a two-shotter, but he ended up passing it. Go up strong. Ah! Who's going to stop him? You got a broom?
That's 12 for the big guy.
You saw that graphic with the fouls, too. So they can just go in and get them in serious trouble.
LSU wants a timeout. 4:31 into the second half. The Gators are right back in it, down by 11.
This is titanium. One of the sharpest metals known to man. Now available in a somewhat more manageable size. The new Remington Titanium Series. The world's only shaver with the sharpness of titanium-coated trimmer blades. For a shave that's incredibly close and comfortable. Remington Titanium. It could just make all other shavers obsolete.
They're as close as two brothers can be. What could possibly come between them?
Well, what do we have here?
Hey, don't you walk away from me.
Yeah, you better run.
From the directors of There's Something About Mary.
Oh, oh, oh.
You guys are fun.
Stuck on You.
Hey, what's the four-letter word for snatch?
Grab. Oh, right. Right. Oopsie.
Rated PG-13, December 12th, only in theaters.
Over a million people understand its strength. It can give you new energy, a new outlook, and an entirely new shape. This is Bowflex Power Rod technology, and it can only be found on genuine Bowflex equipment, like the new Bowflex Extreme. Designed by Nautilus to make losing weight and building muscle more effective than ever. Now you can get the results you want, the exercises you need, all at an affordable price. You've never seen this Bowflex before. Call 1-800-261-7714 now and get the new Bowflex Extreme with no money down and just $19 a month. Getting a high-performance body has never been more affordable. All it takes is a plan, a commitment, and a proven tool that makes getting results so easy. When you're ready to get in shape, look for real Bowflex Power Rod technology and the new Bowflex Extreme. We've won the confidence of over a million people because we mean what we say. We live up to our promises, and ultimately, we deliver results. Women and men of all ages are feeling better, performing better, and looking better with one simple workout done 20 minutes a day, three times a week. Call and find out what Bowflex's Power Rod technology can do for you. All our machines come with a 100% satisfaction guarantee. In fact, Bowflex has several new models for you to see, many backed by a 10-year warranty. Now you can own your very own Bowflex, like the new Extreme, for no money down and only $19 a month. The Bowflex Extreme is not available in stores. You know you're ready. It's time to let Bowflex help you get there. Call now to get a great deal on the professional quality Extreme. Now, just $19 a month.
This week on Sunday NFL Countdown, the latest on Keyshawn Johnson and the future of the Bucs, and how Donovan silenced his critics.
Yeah, I thought about quitting. Yeah, right.
Sunday NFL Countdown, 11 a.m. on ESPN.
Barry Sanders.
It's like trying to catch a fly and you just can't catch the guy.
A Sports Century world premiere Monday.
50, 40, 30. Holy mackerel.
A master playmaker.
He is putting on a show.
But on the verge of immortality.
As a son, this is not the time to quit.
I knew that I was walking away from something that was wonderful.
Sanders said goodbye.
It's still a mystery to me why you quit.
Sports Century Barry Sanders premieres 8 p.m. Monday on ESPN Classic.
It'll be a classic Saturday night at 7, Classic Baseball. It's the Indians and the Mariners from 2001. Then at 10, NFL Game of the Week presents the Bengals-Chargers Showdown from 85 tonight on ESPN Classic.
LSU by 26, 14 and a half minutes into the game, by 16 at the half. Florida has shaved it to 11 with 15 and a half remaining.
Power basketball, great inside passing, and a great look by Dwayne Schintz. The easy finish by Livingston. The tempo up, the heads up. Do you think Norm got after them at the half?
Gators are on a 10-4 run in the last 4.5 minutes. 5 of 7 from the field. Jackson in trouble, almost turned it over.
That's
now, Chapman steals it away from Singleton.
They finally doubled up on the ball. The guard ran at Jackson, helped out Ramos. Gotta do that.
Ramos to Schintz, uncontested.
Let's see if they continue it now. They got the building on their side all of a sudden.
Florida over the long run is on a 28-13 run. After that move by Chris Jackson.
They used the rim so that the big guy, 7'2", would only hurt the pinky.
There's Ramos driving. Nice. And he is hammered by Richard Krajewski.
That's it, isn't it?
That's 5 on him we have.
Now, this is where Dale has some problems. Depth inside. Now, let me tell you, they needed a basket here, LSU. A freshman takes over. If he takes the layup on this side, it's out of here. But using the rim to ward off Dwayne Schintz is really heady play.
Krajewski, no points, 3 rebounds, 5 fouls, and he is gone for the last 14:37. A blow to Dale Brown's depth.
What he did, out there was defensively just played that junk defense the way he was told. So in a sense, he's helped them get this lead.
Jose Ramos averaging 7, looking to equal a season average with this one. 9-point game, long way to go.
And left playing Jackson, look at his blow by speed.
Over Schintz, he got a bounce, but it wouldn't fall. And the Tigers called for a foul. Looks like Singleton with his 3rd.
They ran Ramos at Jackson, and I think that's the secret for Norm. That one could have gone. It was good penetration, an easy shot.
Bill, let me ask you, as a coach, your team's played so well through the first 25 minutes of the game. Now you're Dale Brown sitting there. Can you feel it slipping away?
Can you? Well, your suit was nicely pressed in the first half. Now you start to see wrinkles. You start questioning your assistant, what should we do? I think what he's done is he's going to have Blanton and Jackson take over for him. Run them, their plays, and go to them continually, because They just don't have the inside strength to dump it down and let that guy power.
Ricky, who got that rebound, has been quiet.
Yeah, I don't think he's had a point, has he, this half?
He has not. 19 in the first half. He goes for a couple and draws the foul.
Tell you, that was offense. I know the kids watch the NBA, and Ricky did the smart thing, but the defense, Chapman stayed away, and he leaned into him. Livingston saying nice call, applauding the officials, saying maybe he'll take care of me later.
Ricky Blanton leading the Tigers at 79% from the line. He's 35 points away from the 1,000-point club with his 19 and now 20 this evening.
Steady kid, isn't he?
He's the heart and soul of this team.
He sure is.
No question.
You ought to talk to him if you want to write a book on Dale Brown, right? He's got every motivational and emotional speech, I'm sure, registered.
Back to 11, the Tigers get it. Ramos, Orshitsis, who's becoming ever more involved in the offense. Away from the ball, and that'll be four on Singleton. Four players now with four for the Tigers.
And because they're going inside.
Excuse me, three with four, one is gone. Dale Brown gazing at the officials.
Dale was telling me today he's much more comfortable after all these years. And then I'm reading the notes and I see he got two technical fouls at the end of the game.
Well, that game was over when he got those tees.
I know, but right in here, that's just good post defense. And they don't want the hands on you, but how do you play post defense without touching the man?
In Dale's defense, the clock was on zero when he
right.
got those technicals against Oral Roberts.
But
the game
I was laughing how relaxed I am.
Yeah.
Been in it so long, and bang.
Ricky Blanton dumps it. Right wing, and it goes
home
for
run.
Three for Russell Grant. His first points of the night.
He hasn't been able to knock him down, but every time he shoots, the bench stands up for the home run.
Russell says, I'm not very talented. It's got to rattle around to get three for me.
He works at it.
There's Ramos off Singleton with the rebound.
Now he's done a nice job getting it to the big guys. That time, the freshman thought he deserved one. Can't do that.
Is he going to do it again? It's a little short, but there's Singleton. This guy can really jump.
Nice pump fake with the steps.
Yep.
The start of a pretty good move.
Coming up next, we go from the SEC to the Big East. Seton Hall, ranked number 20 in the nation. They're both undefeated as St. John's provides the opposition next on ESPN.
PJ and Louie banging heads early.
Gotta love that one.
Oh, looking forward to watching that myself.
Well, we'll set you up here in the dark, Jim, and you can stay as long as you want.
But I think I'll find some nice pleasant surrounding.
Here's Schitzes with the turnaround.
Oh, Chapman got away with it.
And transitioning is Russell Grant. Blanton ahead of him. Bounce pass taken away by Ramos.
He didn't need it.
Ricky Blanton was in no position to go to the hoop.
Oh,
Chapman way short.
Then they forgot their inside game. Gators go low.
Russell Grant short. And being careful with four fouls, Vernell Singleton.
He did a good job, you're right. Could have very easily reached down.
There's 22 Grant, the scrapper. There's Singleton, who can jump out of the gym, says Ron Abernathy. And checking in for LSU will be Lyle Mouton, a 6'4", 215 sophomore out of Lafayette, Louisiana. First appearance of the night. He had 0 points against Oral Roberts a couple of weeks ago. 0 for 7 in that game, and he's been on the bench ever since. Ramos checks out. He'll get a breather. And Garcia, Ronaldo Garcia, back in for Florida.
Clifford Lett's done a great job on Jackson.
Look at Ricky Blanton use the screen, but he can't get the shot down. Mouton missing on the follow, but drawing a Garcia foul.
And it's a shot, too. Two shot. He had control. But Clifford Lett has done a great job for Norm Sloan. A nice adjustment at the half. He's denying the ball once he gives it up, and he's really on top of him and controlling him, or at least channeling him to somebody when he dribbles.
Five team fouls on the Gators. LSU has been in the penalty situation for quite a while. That foul on Garcia, his fourth, will force him back out, and Ramos right back in, and Ramos is playing with three. At the line, Vernell Singleton.
The old pro over there, Bob Norm, didn't say anything, let the youngster walk by him. a lot of coaches, including yours truly, occasionally would get after a kid after a mistake, and it doesn't make anybody do any better or feel too good. But the seasoned vet just let him relax.
LSU considering that Florida figures to shoot a lot of free throws down the stretch. Better start making theirs.
This is what they just have to go back to.
Chances for Chapman, and that is foul number 5 on Vernell Singleton.
And as you noted, McHale a little upset with the call, but he definitely was all over him. Vernell has not been able to deny the cut. Chapman is very good. Go back to the well. It got you here, but look at the quickness of Chapman to the glass. Of course, I cut too, because Schitz's loves to give it up. I mean, he makes it worthwhile.
Singleton, 3 points, 4 rebounds. Dale Brown loses him with 12:22 remaining. And Brown now is down to basically 8 regular players and 3 walk-ons.
And all guards. I mean, nobody's over 6'2". Timeout now. He's got to get organized.
He's saying, oh, Stanley Roberts, prop 48, 7 feet tall, 280 pounds. Where are you? Maurice Williamson, a freshman forward who can't play for that same reason. Harold Boudreaux, a freshman guard, out.
I can't wait to see Maurice, if he's anything like John.
Hey, they got to recruit Shaquille O'Neal, a center out of San Antonio. High school player, already signed. He's only 7'2", 245.
But they don't want some big guys to pal around with.
Huh.
Makes coaching a little bit easier.
Livingston Chapman, 16 on the night. Gators with 2 successful ones here could get back to within 11.
This crowd was bordering on being unattractive, weren't they, at the end of the first half?
Ooh.
I mean, they were really down on their club.
Disinterested,
yeah,
is a good word, too.
Yeah. They were going to start going to the swimming events.
How's that for a roll? Sims stripped. Unable to hold it in, but good hustle by Dwayne Davis. Hey, you like to see a guy who's scoreless on the night.
He hasn't
playing
stopped.
Defense like that.
He missed a couple of layups. Here's the good inside post pass, though. Now, you talk about Blanton. Look at that. He gets it in, and he stripped, as you mentioned, great effort inside.
On the inbounds play, a foul on the Gators.
I think it was Jose.
That would be his 4th. Garcia has 4. Looks like they might have to turn back to Brian Hogan here sometime soon. Player known for his defense.
Boy,
number 25 checks in at the table.
Top of that.
Coach, it's our job to know who's coming in next. Sometimes you have to guess, but Hogan is the likely one, and there he is.
I'm impressed with Wayne Schintz this half. He's verbalizing with his teammates, telling them what to do, where to go.
Hey, he's a junior. He's got to start doing that.
He does, and it is a young team in the backcourt spot particularly.
They can't wait any longer for Dwayne Schintz. Gerd Hummick, scoreless on the night, missing. The 6'11 freshman from the Netherlands. Now it's a 12-point LSU lead, but as you can see, lots of time remaining. Schintz posting for Chapman. Left side, Clifford Lett. The only senior on this Florida team.
33's got everybody on his good pass. Give him the ball.
Great entry pass by Chapman, and Schintz has 16.
It's a simple game. Everybody knows it, except his teammates.
Blanton on the line. It would have counted for 2.
Nice.
Schintz wipes the iron, and the Gators could get it into single figures.
And he looked up, saw Lent, and then saw him covered and held on. Here he is again. Still got him. Just throw it high.
Knocked away. Nice D bomb from Lyle Mouton from behind out of the hands of Clifford Lett.
And Clifford Lett is the guy.
Where's Chris Jackson?
Clifford Lett.
Where's he hiding?
He's got him. He's done a great job, a very nice move from a coaching standpoint. He just wasn't going to be stopped by Ramos or Garcia.
Chapman for 2.
That helps the post passing. They needed that from
Chapman with 19. Timeout LSU wants. with 11:06 remaining. They once led by 26. It's down to 8. 66-58, LSU over Florida. The crowd is back in it in Gainesville.
Ace is having a sale.
The Ace One Day Sale is here. Stop in this Friday to save on hundreds of items at Ace, the helpful place.
There's more to protecting your family this winter than making sure they're dressed warmly. You've got to make sure they're protected at home as well. And no one helps protect families better than ADT. A single ADT system can help protect your home and family from burglary, fire, and carbon monoxide. Call now and take advantage of ADT's holiday special. You could even save up to 20% off your homeowner's insurance, and you may qualify for zero down financing for installation. But you better hurry. ADT, always there.
To own your own business and enjoy financial independence? Nationwide Cyber Systems introduces the most exciting business opportunity of the 21st century, the Wi-Fi Public Internet Terminal. This amazing machine offers high-speed internet access, email, and video email for only 25 cents per minute, payable by cash or credit card. The machine is also a wireless access point where up to 100 users at the same time can receive high-speed wireless internet service for only $3.95 an hour or $7.95 a day. Nationwide can start you in a turnkey business and help you secure the most profitable locations in your area before someone else gets them. You can start part-time and expand according to your own timetable. Call now for your free video and information package. There is unlimited income potential. Don't delay. The best locations won't last long.
Foul trouble, a big factor in this game. Two Tigers gone, two others on the verge. Guards for Florida in trouble with 11:06 remaining. It's an eight-point game, 66-58 LSU.
And there's your story right there. If Jackson can get going, that's for LSU a win. Look at that pick by Sims. And if Lett can stop him, then Florida can win it.
Clifford Lett to the hole. Yes!
Wow. That should have been wiped out.
Gators within six. Hamick was straight up standing there. Contact was made. Officials said play on. And the Gators are coming right back.
What a pick earlier. Now Clifford Lett's got to be looking over his shoulder defensively.
Ten and a half minutes remaining.
Not a good pass.
Hogan looked to Lett, tried to dump it down for Davis.
In traffic from the point to the baseline is totally impossible.
Now the officials will overturn the call and say that it was an LSU player that bumped it out of bounds. Jose Ramos will check back in. That was official Danny Hooker down on the baseline.
That's good they're coordinated anyhow. But a gamble pass by Hogan.
Florida could be back to within four, maybe three. Shinsis, too strong, never touched iron with it.
Look at the steal by Wayne
Sims, and that forces a foul.
I don't mind the big guy forcing a shot, though. How do you feel? I mean,
no,
he's got to take as many as he can. I mean, he's got a great touch. And of course, Chapman and Davis underneath, pretty good at cleaning up.
And if you don't think the Tigers might tire out short on the front line trying to guard Shinsis, it plays into their hands as well.
Well, you can't front him because they lob to him so well. He's got terrific hands. You can't help because he passes so well. He never played the Church League, Chapman.
No, because the ceiling would have stopped that shot. I know what you're talking about.
He never played the basement.
A little too short on that one, but he gets it back.
And back. They just pumped up a little bit more. See, now he brings it to his chest. You don't do that.
Shinsis against Hamick. Nice. Dribbles around him.
You see the little tuck with the arm? Heads up play.
3-point game with 10 minutes remaining.
Wow.
That should count for four.
Oh, that's like a senior. The confidence, it's tougher to shoot now for anybody because the game is in the cracker area.
Chris Jackson with 29 now.
You got to see what you got inside you.
Let for three. Looks good, but it's a little long. Davis!
He's been quiet, but that could be the one that lifts.
Jackson for Sims. So we're trading baskets now.
Look at this. They're asleep. No.
And a foul.
You know what happened there? Let's let these people enjoy it. Yeah! Jackson told Mills he was back there. He should have gone and played him until Mills got there. He recognized it and then relied on the slower, bigger man to get back, and Wayne Sims just wasn't up to the task.
Second foul on Ricky Blanton. 4 points the spread. And at the line, Dwayne Davis, suddenly an offensive force. Jackson has 32.
That's two threes, tough, deep, nothing run. That takes a lot of internal.
And it makes it tough on a team that does not shoot three-pointers.
Well, they got the answer, Florida. I would vote on Florida's offense now versus the long jumper here. This is going to be left because you just can't keep going to the well with the deep one.
Clifford Levy's done a good job until the last minute. Chris Jackson here in the second half has drawn his fourth foul.
Actually, it's not a bad job having a guy take a 22, 23 footer on you, is it? Coach, what do you want?
Yeah, go out that far to get in. He'll dance right around me. That's what he's telling me.
And he'll back you up, too.
So Jackson to the line, already with 32 points on the night, averaging 27 coming in. Just pencil him in as a freshman All-American already, and you can put some ink on it maybe a month from now.
And you mentioning the recruits that they have there already, this kid with another year's experience, oh my gracious, how good they can be. But the coach has waited a long time for him to make his decision, and we can see why now.
Oh.
8 points at the tough time of the game.
2 3-pointers, 2 free throws. He has 34 on the night. Shinsis, an outstanding athlete, dribbling it up the floor very comfortably.
He's pretty talented. Here he is again. Give him the ball.
Remus to Shinsis.
Very simple.
14 second half points for Shinsis, 22 in the game.
North Sloan just shook his head saying, why did a nice play by the, now he passed it, he should have shot it.
And he just fouled Clifford Lett out of the game.
And that helps them a great deal. He really should have shot it when he got Lett up in the air though. Good job by Lett. He's helped them get back in this thing.
You know, but it's kind of a role reversal here, Coach. Usually you see a senior working on a freshman. After a time, he'll eventually get him out of there. Here's a freshman who erases a senior finally.
Well, those kind of moves you learn in the NBA. I mean, he's doing them now as a freshman. You're right, but I thought Lett handled himself beautifully. He got Florida back in it with that good aggressive containment. Because that's all you can do with this fine frosh. Ooh, is he tough.
Lett gone with 10 points and one rebound. Brian Hogan, the man they call on now. He's a guy who's provided a good spark off the bench, getting them into their offense this year. He's a good three-point shooter, but what about defense against this guy?
You've got to run a couple of people at him now.
Coach, he's 11 of 11 from the line tonight.
I said to him before the game, do you like CJ? He said, yes. I said, are you going to get 50 for us tonight? And he started laughing. Here's an over the top. I think Shinsis goes to the free throw line.
Looked like Gert Humming with his fourth. So to the other end goes Dwayne Shinsis. Humming, 1 point, four fouls, and on the night, he has three rebounds.
So Jackson shot two free throws, and he passed the ball.
Well, he must
be. Because he made the first one.
That's right.
Bonus situation.
Shinsis has 23. This guy's a good free throw shooter.
He's got a terrific touch. And again, I can't help but we mentioned some of the first half, his great run at the Olympic trials and then going on that tour of Europe versus the Olympic team. And he played against the pros. And PJ Bellissimo coached him up in the trials, said he had a great attitude.
Shinsis threw a good enough brick that it came flying out back to the Gators. Hogan, there's the three.
Kokomo, Indiana. They can all shoot Indiana.
Two-point game, 8-10 remaining. Hogan spelling Lett off the bench with a huge basket.
That's not a good one. Go ahead. Tell me it's not good. That's why I'm out of it.
38 for Chris Jackson. Coach, you wouldn't have any hair left trying to defend against that.
Oh, no, no. I just say, somebody call timeout, get somebody else on him, Coach. Now go back to the well now. Take your time. Bad pass.
Almost a steal by Russell Graham. Right side, Checkman short.
Found his own, though.
Look at that.
Great hustle. He's pulling the string on that jumper. Did it twice.
Chapman and Shinsis, 32 between them in the second half.
You can't keep doing it.
Jackson from at least 25 feet that time. See, now he almost steals, but he gets his fourth foul.
Tell you what, he got that left hand in there. You've got to be careful when you put this ball down. That was pretty good defensive stance and positioning. Whew. Judgment just a little bit questionable now.
Ryan Hogan will go to the line. Four fouls, 38 points for Chris Jackson. Boy, long way to go in this game. 7:25 remaining. Another brick. Blanton had it, and he was fouled. Hogan, the man who missed with his second.
I'll tell you, he's a tough guy. Watching him work out yesterday, he's got a lot of moxie.
Ricky Blanton was 9 of 11 from the field in the first half. In the second half, at one point, he was 0 for 3. Don't remember him with any shots lately, just one. He's now 0 for 4. Does have a couple of free throws. So he has 21 points on the night. 59 between him and Jackson. Chapman and Shinsis have 45 between them.
That's cute. Ramos is looking away with Blanton. Two Miami kids, can you see them?
Ricky says, just pick up the ball, big boy, after I can another one.
I'm sure they bang heads in the summer.
82-77 LSU, what a game. Warren Sloan wants timeout. Second one he's called in the second half. LSU's used a couple. 7:17 remaining, a 5-point thrilling ball game in Gainesville.
John Lynch and his mom are coming to your home.
Hey, how you doing?
John Lynch, how you doing? Very nice to meet you. Come in, let's go.
And they're bringing dinner. New Campbell's Chunky Grilled Chicken and Sausage Gumbo. Hearty chunks of savory meat, veggies, and rice.
What do you say,
sure beats another frozen dinner.
Come on, check out the plate. Do the plate a little bit?
Mom doesn't like me rough.
Come on, you hit me a little bit. Yeah.
Sorry, Mom. Have chunky soup for dinner.
That was great, man.
Make it Campbell's instead.
Oh, 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 oh,
Ace is having a sale.
The Ace One Day Sale is here. Stop in this Friday to save on hundreds of items at Ace, the helpful place.
Want to lose weight and get lean? Want to shed inches and get chiseled abs? Want to get into the best shape of your life and do it in as little as 20 minutes a day and only 3 days a week? Well, now you can on the Crossbow by Weider. Only the Crossbow features the five most important aspects critical to an effective strength training program. 1. Hardcore resistance. The Crossbow's exclusive compound resistance system actually harnesses the power of these bows, allowing you to do multiple repetitions for developing long, lean, shapely muscles. 2. Range of motion. Through advanced engineering and its cable and pulley system, when the Crossbow compounds 1 foot, the cable releases 2, giving you complete range of motion, allowing your muscles to peak with every exercise. 3. Quick change resistance. Because of the Crossbow's breakthrough design, changing resistance is as simple as slipping the ends of the bows under the collar. Going quickly from one exercise to the next allows you to burn more calories by keeping your heart rate up. 4. Total body workout. The Crossbow comes fully loaded with 240 pounds of muscle building resistance. A lat tower for shoulder and back exercises. A leg developer for sculpting the lower body. An adjustable bench for multiple chest and arm exercises, as well as a complete cardio row feature that burns calories while you build muscle. 5. Value. The Crossbow delivers over 65 club quality exercises and space saver design, all for less than half the cost of other home gyms. Call now and put the Crossbow in your home for zero down and as little as $35 a month. Along with your Crossbow, you'll also receive this workout video and wall chart. It's everything you need to begin a safe, balanced, productive fitness program. Only the Crossbow features all five critical aspects to an effective cardio and strength training workout. Call now.
They did it!
The NCAA Women's Basketball Championship, coming in March.
A master playmaker.
He is putting on a show.
But on the verge of immortality, Sanders said goodbye.
I knew that I was walking away from something that was wonderful.
Sports Century, Barry Sanders, premieres 8 p.m. Monday on ESPN Classic.
On Thanksgiving night, for the first time ever, number one Notre Dame, number two Michigan State, the epic battle one more time. The exclusive rebroadcast of the Game of the Century. Plus, Bubba Smith and Rocky Blyer relive the dramatic...
There was some vicious hitting going on.
...and controversial game...
I really felt let down. I felt disappointed.
...that changed college football forever. Classic Big Ticket, the Game of the Century, 7 Eastern Thanksgiving night, only on ESPN Classic.
Ricky Blanton and the LSU Tigers hoping that time will run away quickly. They might have to score over 100 to win this ball game tonight. 82-77. At the half, it was 54-37 LSU.
But it's Florida right now, more control, getting easier shots. CJ proving us wrong, taking the deep ones, and they're hanging in. I don't know if he can continue to do it and have LSU walk out with a win.
Hogan for three. Eats it his last two from out there.
Good for him, right? He just can't move. He is so tough with the dribble. I don't care who you are, the foot speed. This kid is so good with the dribble.
You know, Hogan came into this ball game relatively late. Jackson might get him fouled out too. That's three on him.
He could foul anybody out. I mean, I just think you have to run somebody at him, make him kick the ball, and then try and deny him the basketball. Dale Brown into the pro set right now. I'm thinking of Tiny Archibald, the way he used to run for the Kings and, of course, Texas Western. Dale Brown's let this guy take over, do what he wants. Extraordinary ability. But at times, I think the forced shot can hurt you.
Jackson is 13 of 14 from the line. LSU gets it back to 4 with 6:40 remaining. Hogan too long, and over the top Shinsis. That'll only be his second.
That was a delayed one, though. He didn't really mean that one. He wanted to hold it back. Hogan going to the well. He's got a lot of confidence right now, and that should help get it inside if he can bang those deep ones.
Gert humming to the line at the other end. Dale Brown's freshman, Chris Jackson, only the second player in this building to ever score 40 against the Gators, where they've won 40 of their last 44.
Pressure free throw. But he's had to use everybody up front, hasn't he?
Chris Jackson doesn't even look like he's breaking a sweat, does
he? No. You had mentioned, remember he dunked the ball, and it looked like he just went up nice and easy in the shoot around. I mean, everything is effortless.
Teammates have been known to have passes in their hands from him before they even knew he was passing it. Tonight, no assists, but who cares?
Now he's thrown it to the orange object.
Hogan watched by Russell Grant. Ramos for Chapman. Shinsis dumps it for Ramos, who penetrates left.
That was very unselfish again. See, I think Shinsis should take that. I know it turned out well, but he's got good footwork and, of course, the great touch.
Oh, man.
Oh, would you give me a break?
That's 42.
That's extraordinary.
Hey, you can hear the crowd. They're going, hey.
Well, I mean, the buzz is on. All over the country they're going to be talking about.
There's Dwayne Davis.
New pistol, right? Little pistol or repeat?
You better get your season tickets, LSU fans. You're not going to be able to get into your building for the next 2 or 3 years. Here's
nice
Blanton,
look.
Baseline left. Sims
great,
with a beautiful jump hook.
Great feed. That's one to be acknowledged.
Tigers just have the answer every time the Gators get back very close.
CJ was forced to pass that, wouldn't you say? I don't think he really wanted to kiss it down there to Blanton.
Chapman against Grant. Shinsis, and that is foul number 5 on Gert Hamick, and he is gone. With 5:12 remaining, LSU on top by 5, 89-84. Here at the O'Connell Center in Gainesville, Florida, the Tigers have lost their third player to fouls. Looks like Dale Brown will be calling on Kyle Mouton again. Big East action next for you on ESPN. Seton Hall ranked number 20th against the Red Men of St. John's.
A lot smaller club now, and that's a problem for Dale, particularly with the junk defense. It's not the freak. He said he's only put in one phase of the freak. He hasn't had time. And, of course, that means their defense will improve. But I'll tell you what, the way they're scoring points, they're going to force you to bang your ring the bell. Nice play by Chapman. What a pass.
Shinsis, nice pass down to Davis. And a foul on Mouton, his first.
You almost had a double check, right?
Yeah.
So many fouls.
Somebody only has one foul.
Yeah.
Ramos directing traffic for Norm Sloan.
Norm still got the fire, though. I think he is out there directing traffic.
Dwayne, after a slow start, has 6 points on the night. A Chapman-like free throw that goes way up and gets nothing but net. 89-85. We've got 5:08 remaining. Wayne Sims clears the board after that short one.
We talked about Lett defensively. Chapman's done a great job on Blant. Look at this kid.
Look at the roll!
He is absolutely one of the premier point guards.
Already.
Yeah, I mean, gee, you don't have to talk about class
this
anymore.
This is the fifth game of the guy's career.
Oh, would I go back to coach if I had somebody like him? Look at the crossover between the legs. Now the hesitation. Get him up, deliver, and score the goal.
He just fouled out Ronaldo Garcia. Garcia with 5 points.
Garcia saying, I didn't see anybody like this in Tampa.
Not in high school.
No.
Jackson with a three-point play has 45 on the night. The most ever by a player in this building. And he's not through. Almost 5 minutes left.
Chapman.
He's doing a better job defensively keeping Chinches from touching the ball. He's thrown up high there. Essie.
Rebound, Ricky Blanton.
Occasionally not patient enough. Let the big guy touch it. Something positive usually occurs for Florida.
Ricky Blanton just pulled down his 13th rebound of the night. Jackson seemingly out of control, but keeping within everything. And Grant goes for a long
one.
And that's a three for Russell Grant.
He doesn't even give it the fist in a coordinated fashion. Everything goes herky-jerky.
Chapman inside over Sims.
Great pass by Hogan, too. Good read. Defense broke down, concentrating on Chinches.
Under 4 minutes left.
We can watch this from any camera. It's always going to spell the same thing. Scintillating performance.
47. Hogan for three. Short. Blanton. Chinches knocked it away from him. Bouton will give it back to Mr. Jackson. Chris Jackson with 47 on the night. The previous high in this building, 43 by Charles Bradley of Florida State.
Hogan tried to draw it. All of a sudden, 12. I'd say Jackson 99, Gators 87.
Charles Bradley of South Florida against FSU in this building 6 years ago. Now that record is history. 99-87, 3:21 left.
Ace is having a sale.
The Ace one-day sale is here. Stop in this Friday to save on hundreds of items at Ace, the helpful place.
I never wore black. My old dandruff shampoo always left flakes, so I switched. Sell some blue moisturizing shampoo. Doctor recommended for flakes and itch with aloe moisturizers for healthier hair and scalp. Never wear black without the blue. Sell some blue.
You should be inside the network.
I'm in.
Get your hands on some serious technology, like a compact Presario with a mobile Intel Pentium 4 processor, all for just $9.99 after rebate, plus free shipping. Get what they've got. Get a compact Presario.
A master playmaker.
He is putting on a show.
But on the verge of immortality, Sanders said goodbye.
I knew that I was walking away from something that was wonderful.
Sports Century, Barry Sanders, premieres 8 p.m. Monday on ESPN Classic.
It'll be a classic Saturday night at 7, Classic Baseball. It's the Indians and the Mariners from 2001. Then at 10, NFL Game of the Week presents the Bengals-Chargers Showdown from 85. Tonight on ESPN Classic.
Now on pay-per-view.
What the hell are you doing?
I made a few plans of my own.
The perfect team.
You okay?
Doesn't want to make a score.
You want to start the game up again? That's fine with me.
They want to settle one.
Gold is coming to us. Gonna boost it in transit.
Yeah! Got the Holy Spirit!
The Italian Job.
You just blew the element of surprise.
Surprised?
Now on pay-per-view, rated PG-13.
Made Simple videos are reshaping bodies and changing lives.
Unlike all the quick fix pills, potions, and gadgets that reduce our wallets more than our waistlines, Fitness Made Simple is real, and it delivers real results.
It really works.
I start and end my day with Fitness Made Simple. It works for me.
That was me 70 pounds ago. This is me now.
Fitness Made Simple works. It worked for me, it's working for thousands of men and women nationwide, and it can work for you too.
Order today and get two videos for the price of one.
Imagine somebody coming out of the gate. Look at this. The truth.
Big East next. Seton Hall and St. John's right after this SEC early season battle in Gainesville. 12-point lead for the Tigers, 99-87. Davis to Chapman, around Hogan to Ramos. They got good position for the rebound, and Davis will go up for an easy two.
They got to pressure a little bit, but how do you do it? You got a lot of big guys who don't cover the floor real well. And, of course, with Jackson, I wouldn't want that shot at all.
Why did Lyle Mouton launch that one? Up by 10 with 3 minutes remaining.
Lyle.
Dale Brown can't read.
Boston, yep. You got number 35 having a phenomenal night, Lyle.
Dale Brown wants timeout. Oh. He'll be looking for number 21 first.
He's ready. He is ready for it.
2:43 remaining. Tigers 99, Gators 91 at Florida.
Ace is having a sale.
The Ace One Day Sale is here. Stop in this Friday to save on hundreds of items at Ace, the helpful place.
He's watching me.
All the time. I can't see him.
But he's out there.
I sense it.
On the diamond.
On the court.
On the track.
He pushes himself.
To be better than me.
Better than me.
Better than me.
Better than me.
To be better than me.
Training to beat me.
All by himself.
He's watched my career.
Studied my moves.
He knows my game. He
knows my strengths.
Looking for my weakness.
I don't know him.
I don't know him.
I don't know him.
But he knows me.
Is it you?
Welcome to the world where competition never sleeps. The ultimate online battleground, where you can take on anyone, anytime, anywhere. This is the EA Sports Nation, and it's only on PlayStation 2. EA Sports, it's in the game.
When you want a moment to last forever, it helps to know the people who know diamonds. Celebrate the moment with Zales' exquisitely designed diamond bracelet. Exclusively at Zales, making moments last a lifetime.
Oh, nice ball, Walter.
Only the Fairley brothers, the directors of There's Something About Mary.
Hey, you guys are stuck together.
And Shallow Hal could make a film about brothers. This close.
I'm not going another step until you apologize.
Don't you walk away from me.
Yeah, you better run.
Matt Damon, Greg Kinnear.
Let's never do anything that makes us look like total idiots.
Stuck on You.
I'm open.
Rated PG-13, December 12th, only in theaters. This is titanium. One of the sharpest metals known to man. Now available in a somewhat more manageable size. The new Remington Titanium Series. The world's only shaver with the sharpness of titanium-coated trimmer blades. For a shave that's incredibly close and comfortable. Remington Titanium. It could just make all other shavers obsolete.
They're saying running back by committee is bad for football. I was just saying I see the relevance of committees, just not for running backs. Wait, if I was thinking that, and they were thinking that...
Thanksgiving night, for the first time ever, number one Notre Dame, number two Michigan State, the epic battle one more time. The exclusive rebroadcast of the game of the century, plus Bubba Smith and Rocky Blyer. Relive the dramatic.
There was some vicious hitting going on.
And controversial game.
I really felt let down. I felt disappointed.
That changed college football forever. Classic Big Ticket, the game of the century, 7 Eastern Thanksgiving night, only on ESPN Classic.
A master playmaker.
He is putting on a show.
But on the verge of immortality, Sanders said goodbye.
I knew that I was walking away from something that was wonderful.
Sports Century, Barry Sanders, premieres 8 p.m. Monday on ESPN Classic.
Do It Yourself Weekend. Brought to you by your neighborhood Ace Hardware, the helpful place.
.243 remaining, LSU by 8. Florida backcourt pressure. Timeouts, each team has used 3. Each with 1 remaining.
Very tough team to pressure.
Give it to CJ and clear out.
Well, they got all forwards plus him too, you know?
Finally misses one, tried for his own rebound. Hogan scrapping, and Shinsis comes up with the loose ball. Hey, the Gators are not out of this game yet.
Heck of a pass by Brian Hogan. They just can't get the ball to him now.
Sims and Blanton keying on Shinsis. Hogan for 3.
Oh!
And a little lay Davis.
And he missed one of those in the first half, do you remember? He just wasn't in it, the first 20.
Just had enough push to get it over the iron.
They need a stoppage right here.
The score is 99-93.
What a break. They
now it's 101-93 as Blanton scores at the other end. We want to correct that for you.
That was a break. Didn't really need that basket. It's a good bounce for LSU.
Shinsis. Left side, Chetman, pretty close in,
nice.
But short, and Shinsis with the answer.
They got to get something on the defensive end. It's awfully tough.
Dwayne Shinsis in his three ball games this year, 22, 18, and now 25.
See that? Dale's trying to get him to slow down.
Wow, what an assist that was. Sims from Jackson, 14 for Wayne Sims.
Think LSU will violate the shot clock this year?
What shot clock? Shinsis dumps it. Davis.
Get it to Shinsis. Something positive comes.
1 minute remaining right now in a six-point game.
There's only one timeout left each.
Ryder on Hogan. Fouls him. So that'll be four on Brian Hogan. What an added dimension, though, Coach. The way he dribbles and runs the floor along with his shooting, the ability to foul people out of the game, and in many cases, he might have 40 points with 5 minutes left in the game and be playing against second and third string guards.
That's like your walk-ons.
That's trouble.
You better get pretty deep. I just think you can't let him be played by one man.
The big 5-0.
Well, he did it. What a start.
Coach, I feel like I've been attending a debutante ball here tonight. The coming out of Chris Jackson.
Yeah, delighted to see it.
Good Shinsis shoveled it to Davis, to Chapman, and a foul on Ricky Blanton, his third.
You see Blanton come down and step in, though. Shinsis made a good look. Ricky adjusted very well. This defense has bailed him out again. It stymied the Gator attack. They didn't get the ball to Shinsis for about 3 or 4 minutes, and that certainly helped them get the lead back up.
You know, the Gators had to be encouraged, winning two out of three at the Great Alaskan, beating Siena at home, but then big losses, big time at Florida State and Illinois by a combined 48 points.
And I think the residue of that was the first half, and I think Norm got after them, and we'll find out later, at halftime and reached their pride. They came out with a little bit of involvement. And of course, he's been, you know, in the position, I'm sure, many times in his coaching career, where sometimes the old tongue lashing is more effective than the X's and O's.
And you know, there's something at stake here tonight, the last 39 seconds. The most points ever against the Gators, Pistol Pete Maravich with 52 back in 1970. Jackson has 51. And in the backcourt, Russell Grant fouled by Jose Ramos, and he is adios.
He knew it too as he fouled him, but he had to stop the clock. Hey, Russell Grant does get everything out of his ability too, doesn't he?
So three Gators gone tonight to fouls, three Tigers, 36 seconds left, LSU by six.
Two threes if they miss the free throws.
You're right.
You know, gets them right back at it.
That's why I find it surprising that some of the folks have gone out the doors here. I think they feel as long as number 35 in the background there's on the court, they can't win this game.
They may be smarter than we are.
Russell Grant with seven all in the second half. Hey, stick around. Big East action for you next on ESPN. Seton Hall at St. John's.
Two underestimated people coming into the season. St. John's and Seton Hall.
Shinsis, left side, McKinnon for three, just in off the bench. Kelly McKinnon.
Settle for the two, they gotta give it right away.
Davis has 15, and Grant fouled in the backcourt. Russell Grant, a 71% free throw shooter coming into the game, and he's the man that Norm Sloan's Gators keep sending to the line.
Very impressive performance, not only by CJ, the entire LSU team. You know, there's a lot of glue out there.
Tigers will go 3-2. Gators will end up 3-4. More importantly, though, 1-0 and 0-1 in the conference.
The preacher man gets it done.
LSU will play January 28th at Georgetown. February 25th at home against UNLV. The Gators have a non-conference game later against Stanford. That's why the early start to the conference season here in the middle of December.
Is that Georgetown game at the Superdome? Tough pass there by Hogan.
Uh-oh, here it comes. There's the new record against Florida. Jackson has 53. But Pistol Pete has to be smiling down on what's happening here tonight.
Tough.
Blanton takes it away. The game is over. And LSU on the road wins it 111-101. We're gasping at what we saw from Chris Jackson tonight. 53 points, number 300 in his fine career for Dale Brown in his 17th year at LSU.
The world premiere.
1909 and for Steve Fisher in Michigan. Lewis Bullock finishing out an outstanding sophomore season, fifth leading scorer in the Big Ten at 16 points per game. Ohio State and Randy Ayers honoring outgoing seniors. Otis Winston, Don Gentonio both getting starts, but Damon Stringer makes them go. Sixth leading scorer in the Big Ten at just under 15 per game. He is in the top six in five different individual categories in Big Ten play. Michigan having lost five of their last six and 10 and 11 since they were 8-0 and spent Christmas ranked as the number four team in the country. Since then, the bottom has fallen out and they hope they can salvage an NCAA bid by finishing at 9-9 today. A must situation for the Wolverines.
Ohio State opens up in a 2-3 zone. It's been effective against Michigan the last half of the season.
Travis Conlon, Baylor in the corner, Winston to Baston. Maceo Baston with the first points. His fourth straight start for an inconsistent Gerard Ward at small forward. Deshaun Coleman for the Buckeyes. Here's Stringer. And Bullock chases him almost out to midcourt.
Maybe you see Michigan open up in that half-court man-to-man defense. Big part of it is transition defense today for the Wolverines.
Winston lets go what would have been a two, and the rebound comes down to Bullock. Conlon inside the attractive trailer who shuffles his feet. Well, you could say that the Wolverines' problems this year began, at least in terms of conference play, in the first meeting. They traveled 14 hours back from Hawaii, and Ohio State was able to sneak through Ann Arbor with a 73-71 victory. That snapped a seven-game losing streak at the hands of Michigan, which began with the Midwest Regional Final back in 1992. Missed three by Coleman, and it's batted around the bullet. Stolen by Stringer.